whether or not the results have been sent to CODIS so that we can track this information and finally get to moving and processing all these rape kits that have been sitting on shelves. And the other thing I want to impress on you this morning is that so many women, many of these rapes go unreported, but for the ones that do, there is very rarely a conviction. Some of it, the evidence might spoil for other women. There are great forward. In one of my counties, in my district, over a 10-year period from 2010 to 2020, we had 57 cases that were prosecuted and only one conviction. And getting to the bottom of processing all of these rape kits across the country will bring justice to rape victims and women everywhere. And as Barbara Lee and I have both attested, both of us being victims of sexual assault and rape, the difficulty and challenges that women have to come forward, we just spoke about this earlier, it took me 25 years finally tell my story and to be able to work with partners across the aisle to make a difference in women's lives, to know, for women to know that their voices are heard, that we are going to work hard to get this across the finish line. This bill will be in markup in judiciary tomorrow. We want to make sure that women understand that their voices are going to be heard, actions are going to be taken, we're going to process these rape kits, get this backlog under control, and get states to be held accountable and get them to take action and take it now. And with that, I'm going to hand it over to Representative Lee.
Thank you very much, and good morning. First, let me just take a moment to thank Representative Mace for leading this bipartisan effort, but also for, and for all of you being here today, because, you know, given what is taking place here in Congress, it's always a glimmer of hope for the public to really see Democrats and Republicans working together. And once again, we're working together on this very, very important issue. And to live healthy and happy lives. The law says that rape is a severe offense. But while rape is formally prohibited, it's effectively, quite frankly, decriminalized. One out of every 1,000 sexual assaults, 975 perpetrators will walk free. That's a fact. Only 310 will be reported to the police. Women don't report for many reasons, as Representative Mace knows. After an assault, they're often in shock, trauma says it, unable to process what happened to them. As one who has a background in mental health, psychiatric social work, I know this extremely well, what takes place psychologically as a result of rape. Society has conditioned us, yes, to blame ourselves. Representative Mace bravely, and I mentioned this earlier, there, she shared her story in 2019, and I know it was difficult, but it took her decades to do so because of societal stigma and because of trauma. Women may also not report rape for fear of retaliation. Just look at how this country treated Dr. Ford when she came out with her assault story. Women that do report their assault and get to a hospital can get a rape kit. The police departments across the country are not fulfilling their obligation to test those kits and get justice for survivors. Hundreds of thousands of kits are sitting on shelves while we speak, while rapists go free and survivors are demoralized. The End the Rape Kit Backlog Progress Act would help ensure the voices of survivors are heard by strengthening state and local reporting requirements. My lived experiences drive me in the fight to end violence against women. In the 90s, yes, I wrote the California's Violence Against Women. California, yes, has come a long way, and I'm proud of our state for having reached 5 out of 6 of In the Backlogs pillar great big reform. But with 14,000 untested kids still on California's shelves, that's 14,000, we still have a long way to go. Again, violence against women is an epidemic, and I urge each one of my colleagues to support our bill. Mandate reporting of rape kit backlogs across the nation and help advance justice for millions. Thank you, and now I'll turn it over to Brain, who is our intergovernmental relations advocate and warrior woman. Thousands of untested rape kits nationwide, and each represents a human being who has endured years of trauma and pain. We will not go ignored, and we will not be forgotten. We deserve some form of justice, and the Rape Kit Backlog Progress Act will help get us there.
I knew and saw it as a state lawmaker, the backlog in the state of South Carolina. It's the same issues across the board. Sometimes it's resources, sometimes it's funding, those sorts of things. And so this is just one part of a larger wheel to get at how do we help solve this problem? How do we incentivize states and local law enforcement to move forward and do this across the country? And it needed to be the kind of bill. This is not a messaging bill. This, we worked on this for most of the year, almost 9 months. Chambers,
information that you're doing that bird?
No, there's an added element to this. It's very similar to what happens when there are the
mechanisms for starting situations and I need to call the police.
Oftentimes, the police don't know what they mean, or they turn their head or whatever, and it's the same with this. And the large percentage of the police officers are there, and so we have to understand that there's a dynamic there.
Questions? Great, thank you so much, y'all. We appreciate it very much. Thank you.